Hi, I'm Sarah.
And I'm George Choy. We help you to become financially free so you can spend time with your family, traveling, and pursuing your passions. Welcome back for another video. In today's video, we're doing You Get Paid Even Less Than You Think. Simplicity secret. It's one topic in the huge Enjoy Your Work and Mission chapter of our new book, Simplicity Secret, How to Reduce Overwhelm and Stress, Make More Money, Improve Your Health and Fitness, and Be Happier.
I've got my appropriate t-shirt on today.
And it's available from Amazon, and there's, if you click the link in the description, you can buy it there. Mm-hmm. There's also a really great exclusive interview in Simplicity Secret with mum Sarah Beth Yoga on how she built a seven-figure business from home using the power of simplicity. So definitely read that.
Yeah.
Now, the real cost of working.
So people don't talk about this.
They don't.
No.
They don't. But time obviously is more precious than money, because you can earn money and more money, but you can't get back the time.
Yeah.
So that once that time is gone, that's gone. And maybe you've missed certain things because of that time. Perhaps you've missed your children learning to walk or something like that. Money. Now, you're getting paid even less than you think. There are hidden costs that most people never consider, such as there's the tax. So you're not being paid your full salary. There's obviously tax coming off that.
Yeah.
There's the expenses for your job. There's, you know, what you might have to do to fit in socially with your work colleagues.
Mm.
So there is that pressure to sometimes spend money.
Mm-hmm.
And even more relevant now, due to high inflation, certainly in the UK and America, is the increased costs for everything.
Yeah.
So your salary might not be keeping up with these increased costs, and there may come a tipping point where it's actually not worthwhile to go to work anymore.
Yeah, we'll talk about that in a minute.
Yeah, we're going to get to that. So have a think, you know, if you could bring home the same net cash flow, so after all expenses and tax and so on, and take back 10 to 40 hours of free time per week.
Or a lot more for some people.
Or more,
actually.
Yeah. How would you love to spend that time?
Okay.
It's worth thinking about. So let me share one example from my own life.
Mm-hmm.
So I used to work in the corporate world, and, you know, I was on a reasonably, I'd say, good salary, good high earning salary. You know, I was wearing like tailor-made suits and shirts and things like that.
Expensive shoes,
you know, expensive overcoats, just to fit in with the kind of corporate environment, because it was like a prestigious corporate environment, and meeting with clients where they kind of expected you to look good.
Well, you know, it was brands, so they were expecting you to be wearing some really good stuff.
Exactly. So working with luxury brands, they expect you to look and dress a certain way. And not only that, then with my work colleagues, they all had similar kind of lifestyles and were meeting with clients that, again, kind of expected a certain, you know, appearance from them. So they're all wearing, you know, they're all using like Louis Vuitton handbags and Hermes handbags and things like that.
And going on expensive holidays.
Expensive, you know, Michelin-starred restaurants, all this kind of thing. And it was just kind of expected that to fit in, you also had to talk about doing those things. So there was this hidden cost of being at work.
Well, it was a massive cost for us at the time.
It was, but it's something you don't really think about.
Yeah.
And then, you know, there are the other costs which you just can't avoid from, you know, going to work, such as the travel costs. I would finish work late, and I'd get on a train and go home, and I'd buy some really unhealthy burger meal or something like that. So I had that expense, which I wanted a hot meal because I was cold and tired and so on. And I'd eat that on the way home, because when I got home, I only had time to basically go to bed.
Yeah.
that was kind of it, and repeated over and over again. But not only that, if you actually, you know, looked at your earnings per hour. So if you looked at how much time you spent working and commuting together. So I was getting up early, coming home late. So I was missing, you know, that much of the life. Not only that, I was traveling at weekends. So quite often, like on a Sunday, I would travel to an airport and then fly somewhere, which sounds glamorous, but I'm telling you, it's not once you have to do it all the time. It's just eating alone, traveling alone all the time, which is, you know, it's a very lonely experience. And So if you add that amount of time as well onto it, and then you divided up your salary by the number of hours, you might find that you're better off working less hours, stacking shelves in the supermarket, and you'd get paid more.
And it would be less stressful.
Less stressful. Mm. And you'd reclaim all that time and think, wow, what could I do with that time?
But you didn't.
But I didn't.
No.
But if you're enjoying this video so far and you like these videos, then please do click like and subscribe to receive more videos like this.
Okay. Moving on. So we thought we'd give another example. There was a mentee of ours that we worked very closely with for a number of years. And she was in a corporate job. She enjoyed her job. But she was obviously working long hours. She was catching a train to work. And for her, we didn't have this at the time, but she had two kids. So she was paying for wraparound childcare for both of these children. And she had, you know, she had a husband who was earning a high income as well. So it was barely, once she'd done this exercise on her expenses, it was barely worth working for her at all. There was something in it, you know, she was going to cut her, you know, cost ever so slightly, but it just wasn't worth it for her after she ran these figures. It was a complete revelation that by adding some buy-to-let income, which is what they were doing at the time, she could just quit her job. And she did. So it is life-changing for some people. So we thought we'd talk about how to calculate these hidden costs of working. So know your salary. Obviously, that's a good thing to start off with. So you know how much you're actually bringing in. So what are your costs? How much tax are you paying? How much are you paying for parking and commuting? That can be a big one these days, particularly if you're going a long way. So your train or your car or parking, you know, that kind of stuff. If you've got a car for work, and specifically if it's only for work, we had this situation at one point that we had one car that was literally because of a particular job. How much is that car costing you? How much is it going down? A really big one for a lot of people these days is childcare, because, you know, even if you're getting some free childcare, there's often a big wraparound childcare. Say you're paying a childminder or a nursery, you know, for long hours. That can be extremely expensive, not even to go into, obviously, seeing your children, which is always a nice thing. Are you going out for lunch with your colleagues? Are you spending in the bar after work, you know, to decompress? That can be a big one for some people.
I was going to a coffee shop twice a day.
Yeah.
Getting a large coffee. So, you know, what's that? I don't know, like £8 a day or something.
Yeah, it all adds up. Coffee. Anyway, are you paying for dry cleaning? That can add up as well. And then obviously George was talking about the need to fit in. How much are you spending on designer clothes, say, or luxury restaurants, just to be, you know, okay with these corporate people? Because, you know, it may be something you really enjoy, but it may be something you're really just doing to keep up appearances, and it's not optional.
It could also be, because I've been in some companies where, like, every Friday they finish work early and all of you have to go off to a bar, and you all spend the whole afternoon
and you're buying
drinking,
rounds,
buying rounds for each other.
So that can be an enormous cost for some people. And one last thing that we thought we'd mention as well. So say you're doing this job, therefore you have no time. So what are you paying for, which you would otherwise be able to do? Are you paying for a cleaner? Are you paying for someone to clean your car? Are you paying someone to do your gardening? You know, I mean, it may be that you don't want to be doing these things and you still want to be paying somebody for it. But if you were not working and you had loads of time on your hands, maybe you would be doing those things. So that can be a cost you can add into that as well, if that's something that you would take on yourself. And then the last big one, stress and mental health. I mean, anyone who's heard our story before knows that it destroyed George's mental health, this corporate job. So how much is that worth to you? Are you in therapy because of it? You know, is your marriage breaking down? That's a bit of a cost. Do your kids ever see you? Is that something that you want to put into the mix? Obviously, that's not a financial number you can just add in, but it's something worth considering. So what should you do? Look at your real costs of working. And if you've got a partner living in the house, look at both of your situations, because, you know, one or other of you potentially could be giving up your work. And if one of you gave up your job, how much would it really cost you in real terms now with your current situation? But just saying, if it's not feasible, if you look at it and just go, well, that's never going to happen, could you switch to part-time in your current role? Because you may find that actually makes a big difference if you can then you know, say you work 4 days rather than five, could you then do something amazing with that fifth day that would, you know, cut your costs down significantly?
Oh, and also maybe could you work from home permanently?
Yes.
That also can then cut out a lot of those
Exactly.
expenses.
A lot of people have done that, or people are negotiating to stay at home at the moment rather than having to go back into the office, say. You know, would you net more real income or time or health? I think the answer would probably be yes to a lot of those questions. So everybody's situation is very different. You have to look into exactly where you are. We can't tell you what is the right answer. It may be that you're happy in your job and you're staying there. No problem at all. But for some people, this is a real lifesaver. It can be completely life-changing by just looking at how much is this really costing you in every area of your life. So I hope this gave you some insight moments. Let me know in the comments below if there's anything that you took out of this that you thought would be really interesting for you in your situation.
Yeah, and if you want to learn more about how to enjoy your work and mission, mm-hmm. make more money, then please order a copy of our new book, Simplicity Secret. There's a link in the description below. Mm-hmm. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.
Bye.